Bro, look at me. With this type of style, would she be able to be a successful engineer? I'm not wicked, though. All I want for this girl is to be happy and successful.
Why you sound like this?
Am I sounding? Keep your mouth shut.
You're not a job, baby. It's not just mathematics.
What kind of girl will you do? How many people will you do that you'll be able to buy me a car?
I'm going to be an engineer.
Is about to start soon. I know you're really anxious for your child to do well, but I'll tell you something. Please remember this. Among the students who be sitting for this exam, there's an artist who doesn't understand mathematics. There's an entrepreneur, there's a business person who doesn't care about history.
There's a musician whose biology marks don't matter.
There's a sport person, there's an athlete person whose physical fitness is more important than English. See, if your child gets a top mark, it's great, it's okay. But if he or she doesn't, please, do not take away your self-confidence and dignity. Tell them it's just an examination. Some kids are smart, but their grades don't tell the same story. Do not judge them. It's just an examination. They are made up for more greater things in life.
Do not think that doctors and engineers are the only successful and happy people in the world.
One exam or low mark won't take away their dreams and talents. Do not cause them. Do this, and then when you do, watch your child conquer the world.
Every scientist will tell you that two brains are not the same, and every parent with two or more children will confirm to this claim.
Imagine this. Should the doctor prescribe the same drugs for all his patients? The result will be tragic. Some will get well, while some will still be ill. This is the same thing that happens when it comes to school. You find a teacher standing in front of a class, about 30 children, young children. Each of them is having different gifts, different needs, different weakness, different strengths. Yes,
the teacher teaches the same thing the same way.
It's outlandish. You find some students in class, all they do is watching other students. They think they are useless.
Believing they are stupid.
See, parents, the way to prove that your child understands something is not merely through a test, memorizing facts and deeds. Then you take a test and forget about it a week later. What good does that do? It's so true. When people say best way read, nine serious, but the one way pass, nine notebook. And it's so sad that school isn't about learning anymore. It's about passing. Do you think bubbling in a multiple choice question, objective and theory, will determine true success in life? It's so sad that students who could not compete to get an A are not given opportunities. Yes,
majority of them have great, wonderful, outstanding and raw God-given talents and abilities that schools don't recognize.
I have read of some persons who dropped out from school because the teachers thought they were stupid and dull. See, today I bring you good news. Those persons are now great men and women of Paragon, billionaires, inventors, CEOs and great authors. Majority of the people who dropped out from school are the people we learn about in school. I mean, the school dropouts are in our history books. George Washington, Bill Gates, Abraham Lincoln. So do not feel too bad when the school tells you that they can't see anything good in you. Because I've been told the same story. See, all my years in primary, junior and secondary schooling, I never got engaged in any social sport activities. I attended different schools. The school would always say, "Lucky, you're not good." You see, I was never given any position, not even to write names of noisemaker. You see, my teacher always say, "Lucky Udu, you are not going to be great. You are not going to be successful. Lucky Udu, you are not going to be known if you do not pass our test, if you do not pass our examination. Lucky, you do not know mathematics. You are not going to be famous. You are not going to be outstanding." Hello, everyone. Let me tell you something. I do not have much faith in school, but I do have faith in people. I'm Lucky Udu. I'm here to endorse love. I'm here to endorse the prosperity of the next generation. Let me ask you a question. What if the cure for cancer or HIV exists in a child who sits at the back of the class, who is not being engaged, not being motivated, who doesn't raise a hand to answer or ask questions? A child who is not being counseled or receiving encouragement from friends, teachers and family, but the cure for a disease exists inside that child. Do you know that if that potential or idea was tapped into, it could save billions of lives? But right now, they are just being judged by how well they perform in their exams. J.T. Van Thierry. Africa, thanks so much for watching this video. My name is Lucky Udu. I'm a Nigerian from Delta State, Akpo, Ikano State local government. I'm a motivational speaker, a student of Elizabeth University Mass Communication Department. Thanks so much for watching Ika TV. Keep watching Ika TV. I'm